Hi, and welcome to the second vlog of the Owls Readathon. And I'm actually starting this vlog with some book mail, which I've already opened. But basically, a few weeks ago, I was telling my boyfriend that I wanted to buy the first Hunger Games book because I want to reread them and I want to have my own copies of the books. And I had already gotten the Catching Fire and Mockingjay, if you've seen my book haul. You know that, and I was telling him that I wanted to buy the first book, and he was like, oh, I'm so glad you tell me that, because I actually ordered that book for you, and it's probably arriving soon at your house. And to be honest, I was completely shook, and today I got this in the mail. And now I have the complete set of the books, and even though they're from the same publisher, the finishing on these books is different. This one has like a matte finish to it and these ones are like shiny, but to be honest, that doesn't bother me. They still look good together, so now I can finally start rereading these books. And I'm actually going to buddy read this with my boyfriend because he has never read them, and we're probably going to be reading them in May. And what have I done already today? Basically, I've done nothing. It's 3 p.m. and I've only like finished editing the last vlog, and that's it. I've done nothing. I've read nothing. I really don't feel like reading even, but I'm going to be reading a couple of chapters of Before the Devil Breaks You. I'm still on page 30, I think. To be quite honest, it's not that I don't want to read anything. It's that I don't want to do anything. I just feel like laying in bed and looking at the ceiling, and yeah, I'm really unmotivated, basically. But I'm gonna force myself to read a bit. Maybe by reading I can get out of this funk. Also, another thing that I've been thinking a lot is, how do people vlog like every week for like years? Because I've been vlogging for 2 weeks and this is exhausting, to be honest. I love it, and I love editing, and I love posting, and I love seeing people like my vlogs, but it's exhausting at the end of the day. And yeah, I don't know how people do it, but I'm willing to do this for a few more weeks now in a row. And yeah, let's get to reading. So this day has been truly chaotic. I've tried doing a million things today and nothing is working. I just still feel very unmotivated and down, to be honest. And I don't know why. And I'm about to make this day even more chaotic because I'm about to dye my hair. I was already planning on doing this tomorrow, but since I'm feeling like shit, I just want to feel a bit nicer with freshly dyed hair. So you probably don't know, but this is not my natural color. My hair is naturally light brown or a dirty blonde, and I've been dyeing my hair black for the past 5 years, and I always do it at a hairdresser because I don't trust myself, especially with black dye. It gets everywhere, but whatever, I'm just gonna do it at home. I have the dye that I use right here, and I'm gonna try and do it by myself. I'm not sure how this is gonna go. Also, I'm aware that you can't even see my roots coming in, but I can see them. In real life, you can totally see them, so yeah. Thank you.
hi, it's a new day, and since yesterday was so shitty, I ended the day feeling very unaccomplished because I basically didn't do anything the whole day. I didn't read, I didn't do anything. Like, so from now on, I think I'm going to try and force myself to do stuff so I feel a bit more accomplished, and try and do a to-do list every day with things that I want to do, just so I can hold myself accountable and actually do stuff, because yesterday I didn't feel like doing anything, but also I didn't really know what to do. So I think if I make a to-do list every day, I think I'll have a better plan in my head of things that I should do or that I can do. So all of that to say that basically I have some things that I would like to do today. One of them is read, obviously, but I want to get like to page 100 of Before the Devil Breaks You. I have an arc for a graphic novel. I'm not sure what the name is. I think it's LA Ghosted or Ghosts in LA, something like that. But I want to read that graphic novel, and that way I can complete the prompt to read a book that is less than 150 pages. I'm not doing all of the prompts, obviously. I'm only doing the ones that I have to do for my career, but if I can manage other prompts, I will do them just to have a bit more flexibility in the careers that I want. So yeah, maybe I'm going to start that graphic novel. Going to read till page 100 of Before the Devil Breaks You, and I want to continue with my watercoloring classes because I'm only on like class 4 or 5, and I want to do more because it's really fun. So yeah, that is my plan for today. I've already done a lot of cleaning as well that I needed to do, and yeah, let's get started. The setting. Yeah, I just filmed the video basically. I have the house to myself, so I decided to take advantage of that and film a video. I filmed my March wrap-up, which is probably already on my channel if you want to check it out. And now I'm gonna go back to reading. Hi, so I'm so glad that I actually forced myself to be productive yesterday, because today it's already 3 p.m. and I've already done a lot, to be honest, and I just feel like doing a lot of stuff today. I'm still not completely over my funk, but I think I'm getting there. And so today I've already vacuumed my whole room. I have also edited my video, which is now exporting here, my March wrap-up, and I also finished the graphic novel that I started reading yesterday. And I realized that I didn't even tell you what the graphic novel was, but that graphic novel was Ghosted in LA Volume 1 by Sina Grace, and it's basically about a girl that goes to LA to study because her boyfriend is also studying there. And one day she stumbles into a mansion that seems abandoned but is actually habitated by a lot of ghosts that stay there and have been stuck there, and she basically befriends the ghosts. I know, it's weird. I give it 3 stars, and I don't know, I read it very fast and I was interested in the story, but I just don't see myself
keep reading the next volume. So yeah, it was I think it was just kind of forgettable. Things were happening very fast. And it was so weird because she met the ghosts and was like, oh my god, ghosts! And then like a second later they were talking like it was nothing. And she was like, yeah, my friends are ghosts. And it was so weird. And the art style wasn't really my favorite. And yeah, that was it. It was an okay experience, I guess. And now I'm just gonna continue reading Before the Devil Breaks You, which I'm really enjoying, except for the fact that I feel like Evie and Jericho are gonna end up together again, and I don't like that, but I'll just continue reading and see what happens. But before I go, I just wanted to talk to you about social media in this time that we're living in, because I feel like I can't keep my hands off my phone. I honestly feel like throwing my phone off the window just so I can touch it again, because I have been spending so much time on my phone. It's actually unhealthy for me, because I spend a lot of hours just scrolling and browsing and whatever on my phone, and then at the end of the day I just feel like I wasted a lot of hours on my phone scrolling and doing nothing productive and nothing interesting, to be honest. I just mindlessly scroll, and I feel like I'm not the only one that has been experiencing this and been struggling to not be on my phone all the time. And before all of this happened, I had a screen time of about 2 hours, which wasn't really bad, I guess. I feel like it's not that bad nowadays, but I still wanted to get it up to like an hour and a half or something. But now that all of this happened and I've been in the house so much and I've been on my phone a lot, my screen time has almost doubled what it used to be, and I just don't know what to do to get myself to stop. I need your advice, to be honest. I'm kind of asking for advice. And also, as I'm saying this, I'm gonna go check my screen time on my phone, because I haven't checked in like a week. A week ago it was like 4 hours and something. It really depended on the days, because sometimes I would spend like 5 hours on my phone and other times I would spend like 2 or 3 hours. Now I don't really know where I'm at, and I'm gonna check. Okay, so this is bad. I'm gonna show you. So my screen time is 4 hours and 38 minutes. Yeah, this is not good. I need help, honestly. And the thing is, the time that I spend the most on my phone is at night before I go to bed, and that is super unhealthy. It just messes up with your sleeping, and yeah, that is the time that I spend the most on my phone, between midnight and 2 a.m. I don't know what to do. I thought of taking out all my notifications just so I don't check it as much, but I don't know if that will help me. And I also already have time limits for my apps, and that isn't helping because I just keep adding up 15 minutes at a time when I hit the limit. And I don't know, tell me what you're doing to keep off social media and your phone. And if you're also struggling with this, remember you're not alone. Everyone has been spending too much time on their phones. It's normal, we're all at home and we're bored, and it's a comfort. To me at least, my phone is my comfort. And when I don't feel like doing anything, I just go there. So yeah, that is what I wanted to talk to you about, and now I'm gonna read and get off my phone.
Hi, so yesterday I spent the whole afternoon learning the Savage TikTok dance. I don't really know why, because I don't even have a TikTok and I don't plan on making one, so I'm going a bit insane. So I ended up not reading as much as I would have liked to read, but I still edited a whole video and I started editing this vlog, so it wasn't that bad. But today I feel even better than I've been feeling the last couple of days, because it has been raining for the past week and today's sunny, so I just instantly feel better. The weather affects my mood a lot. And now for a reading update, which is why I'm here. I don't have an update for Before the Devil Breaks You because I didn't read that much since I last talked to you, but I just realized that I haven't shared the prompt that I have already completed for this readathon, so just gonna do that quickly. As of right now, for the prompt that I need for my career, I have finished Astronomy, which was the Starless Sea, and I have finished Charms, which was Mad, Bad, and Dangerous to Know. So I finished those two, and I still have Divination, which is Stalking Jack the Ripper, and History of Magic, which is this one. And then for extra prompts that I just felt like doing, I have completed Potions, which was a book under 150 pages, which was LA Ghosted volume 1. And I always like to be listening to something on audiobook, and right now I'm not listening to anything in particular, but I did start the Raven Boys audiobook last month. I read like 2 chapters, I think, and maybe I'm gonna continue with that one. People have said that the audiobook for that series is really good, so maybe I'm gonna read that one this month as well, and I'm gonna count that as the Care of Magical Creatures prompt, which is to read a book with a creature with a beak on the cover, and the cover has a raven, so makes sense. And I could count The Great Gatsby as arithmancy, which is to read something outside of your favorite genre, because I don't really read a lot of classics, so I could count that one, maybe I'm going to. And that way, the only prompts that I don't do are Ancient Runes, Herbology, and Muggle Studies, and Transfiguration. So I still do a lot of prompts, and that way I can have more options for the newts and my career. So before the career that I chose, I've already done half of the prompts, so I'm on a great path, to be honest. And also to update you on my social media situation and my addiction, basically, I have uninstalled Twitter and Instagram from my phone, at least today. I don't know if I'll continue with this, but those are the two main issues with me being on my phone all the time. I'm always on Twitter, especially, and I lose a lot of time on Instagram just looking at other people's lives, so I just thought I would uninstall them and see if my screen time goes down. It probably will. And yeah, today I'm gonna focus on reading. Maybe I'm gonna go outside because it's sunny. Yeah, I'll talk to you later. So I know I haven't been updating you a lot on my reading and on my days, but I just haven't had anything to say, really. I am still reading Before the Devil Breaks You. I'm about 200 pages in still. I haven't been reading that much, to be honest, but I'm really enjoying the book. I feel like I can't go wrong with a Libba Berry book. I always like it. And I read a bit of this morning while I was outside enjoying the sun. I actually think I'm getting a bit tan, which is nice, but at some point the sun was too hot for me, so I had to come inside, and I decided to do a bunch of cleaning, like cleaning my bathroom and my windows and just boring stuff. And I took advantage of that time and I started really listening to the audiobook of The Raven Boys by Maggie Stiefvater. And I'm really liking it. It's a weird story and at first I wasn't really understanding what was going on, so I had to go to Goodreads and read the synopsis, which I usually don't do. I usually just start reading a book and don't even know what it talks about, and I pick up the story very fast, but this one I wasn't really understanding, so I had to look up the synopsis. And I think I'm 40% in on the audiobook, and I'm liking it so far. The only thing is that sometimes when listening to audiobooks I tend to space out, not very much, but sometimes I space out for a little bit. And in this audiobook, if you space out for 2 seconds, you get lost in the story, basically. If I don't listen to everything, I will get lost, so I really need to concentrate a little bit more than most audiobooks. But yeah, those are my updates until now. I hope I can read more of this in the next few days. I'm probably not gonna finish it this week, but probably in the next vlog I will have completed this. So it's Easter Sunday today, and even though I don't celebrate Easter, I still decided to look a bit nicer and more presentable than what I usually look like now. And yeah, I'm really feeling this look and outfit, and especially the headband. I think it looks very cute. I actually found this little thing yesterday when I was cleaning, and I was like, yeah, it's perfect for a little headband, and it has flowers, and I really love it. And I just had lunch, and now I'm thinking I'm gonna go outside and read, because it's the last sunny day we'll have in a while. I checked the weather app, and it's gonna rain next week, so it's really unfortunate, so I'm gonna enjoy the weather now and read, and that's it. So those are my only plans for this afternoon. And I'll catch up with you later. So I actually thought it was gonna rain today, but I apparently was bamboozled because it's sunny. So I just came back from a walk outside and I was listening to The Raven Boys while I was strolling. And I'm already 56% done with the audiobook, and yeah, things are happening and it's pretty fun. And I finally memorized the Raven Boys' names because I was always mixing them up, but now I know who they are individually. And as for this book, I read a bit yesterday at night and today in the morning, which I never do. I never read in the morning, but I did today. And I'm on page 313, and this book is spooky. Like, last night I was reading it and I had to stop reading because I was getting very spooked out. And yeah, just the whole setting of the asylum, and yeah, it was really scary. And it reminded me of American Horror Story, the second season, which was also in the asylum. And even though it's spoopy, I like the vibe. And shit is finally hitting the fan, and I am here for it. I'm here for the drama, and I'm here for the development, and I am really liking it. No surprise there. And I think this will be my last update in this vlog, because I still need to edit all of this, and I think I'm gonna do that tonight. So the rest of my day is going to be pretty boring. And I will see you on my next vlog.